After failing miserably to produce a British transport film, and after being shipped to Scotland for an alleged holiday, Owen, Alan and Ryan had somehow managed to get back to the Dark Railway safe and sound. Ah, oh, come on, it wasn't that bad, Alan. A holiday's what you make of it. That haggis was awful. You didn't even eat any. I know, but it looked disgusting. All right, you two, settle down. I have an important announcement to make. Don't you always? Can it, you? So, all of you may be pleased to know that Dave is finally coming home. Ah, yeah! Fantastic! Yeah, boy! Who, Dave? Yeah, I'd like to know too. Dave is my Stania Black 5, and he's the main character of this series. He's been on the line for many years, and is a useful addition to my fleet. In fact, he can pretty much do anything I ask of him. When he can be bothered. Sir, not to be rude or anything, but why is it taking so long to repair Dave? Well, he was overhauled pretty quickly, to be honest. I managed to fast-track him after you guys gave me the money to buy Leno here. He nodded towards Leno, who grinned back. In any case, once he was fixed up and ready to work again, my dear friend, Baron Rhys Davies of Pontypool, wished to borrow him for a short time, so I sent Dave off to Wales for a little while. But now, Lord Davy did not require his services, so Dave should be sent back within a week or two. Woo! Yeah! Woo-hoo! Excellent! So, I want all of you to work on cleaning up the line a little bit. The usual practices. Theo, Otto and Leno shall clean up the quarry. Alan, Colin, Eddie, the industrial estate, please. Everyone else tried to make sure the other station's all clean and tidy. Got it? Yes, sir!
Yes, sir!
Yes, sir! Excellent! Now, back to work! A few days later, Brian and Raymond were to be found at Gallon Junction, after spending most of the afternoon organising the coaches and hiding some disgusting old wagons at Colhapper. I can't wait for Dave to get back. I can. It's been nice and peaceful while he's been gone. And have you noticed something else, Ray? What? We haven't been involved in any ridiculous plans whilst he hasn't been here, or any money-spinning schemes, or any kind of shenanigans. That's true. Anyways, I'll certainly look forward to telling him about everything that's happened whilst he's been gone. But nothing has happened since he's been gone. Yes, Eustace has pulled a few trains, 257 Leno were bought by Mr. Dark, the Diesel Shunters messed up their British transport film, and I'm blue. Nothing that fantastic, really. At least with Dave here, exciting stuff happened. Wait a second, who's that? Dave? Dave? Is that you? If it were Dave, don't you think he might have come and said hello? Yeah. Yeah, fair point. I wonder who that was. Probably just some picking up a ballast train from Soma or something. Well, I'm going to sleep. Good night. Good night, mate. Meanwhile, up at Soma, Theo, Otto and Nino were working very late indeed, trying to get a big order of rock ready for export the next morning. I'm tired. Same here. Fine, we'll leave it here for tonight, guys, and we'll set to work in the Who's that at this late hour? Sounds like a Black 5. No, it couldn't be Dave, could it? Hey, Dave! Oh, it's 9 to 6... Wait a second! You're not Dave! No! Please! Wait! No! God damn it! Working here on my own in the dead of night? Ugh! It creeps me out. Especially after them lot went missing from Soma that night. Jeez, I just hope that other engine gets here sooner rather than later. It's creepy here. Oh, thank goodness. Are you here to collect your... Wait, what are you doing? What's that? Help! Help me! Help! Oh dear, I'm really, really tired. Oh, right, I suppose I'd better... Oh! Oh! My! It is you! What are you doing here? What are you? No! No! Get off me! No! Help! So, as you can plainly see, we have pretty much lost everyone. And I have no idea where they all are. To have an entire fleet disappear within a couple of nights is disturbing. Really disturbing. Do you have any ideas who is behind it, sir? I mean, what happened to Raymond? He's been missing for 3 days. The last I know, he had reached Portsmouth on time, and he definitely got to Port Montu, but he hasn't been seen since. And what about Owen, Alan and Ryan? Well, their driver telephoned to say that they had arrived at the Diesel Shunters convention and that they would be home that night. But that was 5 days ago. This is bad, really bad! Something's out here, and I want to know what... Look, I'll try and find out where they've all gone. For now, you three are my only engines. And Dave should be here tonight, so that'll be a blessing. Brian, Colin, you two are to stay at the junction tonight. Wait up for Dave if you can, and explain to him what's happened. 257, you're coming with me. Where are we going, sir? To try and find out where everyone has gone. Now you two, be on your way. 257, please go and get ready. Brian and Colin did as they were told, and headed down to the junction to wait for Dave to arrive. 257 Squadron passed them later in the evening, whistling farewell as he did so. The two steam engines felt rather spooked out. All of their friends had mysteriously disappeared over the last week or so, ever since Mr. Dark had told the engine that Dave was returning. Ever since... Oh my God! What? I've just remembered! That engine! An engine came to the line the night Fear, Otto and Leno disappeared! Maybe that's the engine behind the disappearances! Do you remember what it looked like, Brian? Not really. It was definitely something XLMS. I know that. And it had a Stanier whistle. It couldn't have been Dave, could it? No, we called, but the engine didn't respond. Well, then I don't know. Anyone with a grudge against us? Howard, maybe, but he isn't a steam engine. And it was definitely a steam engine. The only logical conclusion is... Hold on, what's that? A large familiar-looking engine was backing into the shed. Hey, hey, hey! I'm back, bitches! Dave, it's you! Thank God! Missed me, have you? Ha! Not in the slightest, old friend! Ha! Well, where's my welcome home party? Where's Raymond? I've expected him to be here at least. Well, we need to ask you about that. Oh? The thing is, Dave, everyone's gone missing. And an engine fitting your description was spotted the night the disappearance started. What? It's true. Me and Raymond called after a green Stanier engine that night, and it looked a lot like you. No, it can't have been me. I've been at Newport for the last few months. Besides, why would I kidnap my own friend? I don't know. But 257 Squadron's gone off with Mr. Dark to see if he can find anything out. Well, that's great. No one's here apart from you two. What a bummer. I guess we'll just have to wait till... OH MY GOD! Oh, God. Oh, what the... Brian, what the hell happened? Dave! Dave! Brian, it's her! Who? What are you? And he stared in disbelief as an engine rolled forward towards him. This engine had been stalking his nightmares for years, weaving in and out, the shrill voice cackling inside him, a terrifying yet beautiful figure who once tried to kill him. Dave was speechless. It seemed almost dreamlike as an engine came closer and closer. Leanne had returned.